To tell you the truth, I had to go into NHL 17 and download the very earliest day one roster to get this gameplay. This is the roster of the team at the end of the 15-16 NHL season. So without further ado, let's talk about even more of the best lines in hockey. This time, we're going to be taking a look at one of the most stacked CHL lines that we've seen this century. This is the 2015-16 London Knights first line, which included Christian Dvorak, Mitch Marner, and an undrafted Matthew Tkachuk. This 15-16 London Knights team was absolutely stacked. 51 wins, 14 regulation losses, 0 overtime losses, and 3 shootout losses. Overall, a plus-minus in wins to losses of 51-17. This was a crazy good team, and their top line of Dvorak, Marner, and Tkachuk absolutely led the way. In the total 66 games played, which none of these three players, mind you, played all 66, the trio combined for 344 points. Christian Dvorak led the London Knights and was second in OHL scoring with 121 points. Mitch Marner was second on his team and third in the league with 116 points, and Matthew Tkachuk, third on his team but fifth in the OHL, grabbed 107 points. In terms of goals, Christian Dvorak grabbed himself 52 goals, good enough to put him at number 1 in that category in the OHL in its entirety. In terms of assists, Marner and Tkachuk each got 77 assists, tying them for number 2 in OHL assists. It's incredible, just looking at the numbers that these guys were able to put up just as far back as 2 years ago. Although, this was definitely an ephemeral line. Everybody knew that it was going to come to an end quickly, and this was because of just the overall status of these players at the time. Christian Dvorak, drafted in the second round of the 2014 draft by the Phoenix Coyotes, he was in his last year of London Knights OHL eligibility. Mitch Marner recently got drafted by the Toronto Maple Leafs, and a lot of people were expecting him to make the Maple Leafs next season. And as for Matthew Tkachuk, this was his last season in the OHL, as well as his draft year, seeing as he made the Calgary Flames right after training camp. This was 1 year that all these guys were here together, and it was the only year that they lasted. This was, truly, one of the best lines the London Knights had ever seen, even going back to the lines like Corey Perry, Ryan Hare, and Mike Stathopoulos. The only other line that I could probably say was better than this one was the Patrick Kane, Kostitsyn, and Gagné line, which we'll probably talk about later in this series. But right now, this line of Tkachuk, Marner, and Dvorak is one of the best lines we've seen in the past few recent years. And arguably, it's one of the more impressive ones, considering that they weren't really together to start off the season. It's noted here by Matthew Tkachuk that Marner and Dvorak were the 1-2 center punch. And for the most part, Tkachuk played on both of their wings. They spent most of their time away from each other, and spent a little bit of time on the power play together, but up until November, they hadn't really been on the same line. But once November rolled around, that's when they started getting played together on the even strength, and this is when they went on a tear. And honestly, this London Knights team was truly, truly dominant in every single aspect, because it wasn't even just that first line that was really good. Aaron Berisha, JJ Pichnich, Max Jones, these guys in the middle six of their forward core still managed to each get 50 plus points. Berisha grabbed himself 72. And on the back end, Olli Olevi and Victor Mete was an incredible first pairing for them, each with 30 plus points. Olli Olevi, by the way, was also in his draft year, so Matthew Tkachuk and Olevi both played in that role where they were fighting for draft spots to be taken earlier. Obviously, we all know how that happened. Olevi was taking the pick before Tkachuk, and now Vancouver Canucks fans are pissed, but this video is not really about that. It's about the stacked line. Going into the playoffs, things were incredibly stacked as well. Because if you want to look at the playoff race for the London Knights back in this era of hockey, just gotta look at the playoff scoring leaders. That's it. Because in the OHL playoffs, the playoff scoring leaders were led by this top line, yes, but the numbers are incredible. In 18 games played for the London Knights in the OHL playoffs, which they very obviously won, Mitch Marner, he led the playoff race, 44 points and 16 goals. Tkachuk, 20 goals, 40 points. Dvorak, 14 goals, 35 points. These three guys combined for a total of almost 120 points in 18 games. And they truly, truly were a dominant force in the OHL playoffs. They only lost two games the whole playoffs, and they were both against the Owen Sound Attack in the first round. After the Owen Sound Attack, however, against the Kitchener Rangers, London swept them. Against the Erie Otters with Dylan Strome, London swept them. And in the finals, against the Niagara Ice Dogs, London swept them as well. A very, very impressive playoff performance by each of these three guys and the rest of the London Knights was the ultimate catalyst in their success this season. And so we move over to the Memorial Cup, which the London Knights, they won as well. In the four games that the London Knights played in the Memorial Cup round robin and the tournament, Mitch Marner, he did it again. In four games played, Mitch Marner grabbed himself 14 points and two goals. Christian Dvorak, 7 goals, 12 total points, and Matthew Tkachuk with 5 goals and 8 points. So all in all, this incredible first line combined for 34 points in 4 games in the Memorial Cup tournament. It's kind of crazy to think that the London Knights almost lost in the final. They completely dominated the opposition up to that point. Their first game in the round robin against the Red Deer Rebels, a 6-2 win. This one, Christian Dvorak grabbed himself 2, Mitch Marner grabbed himself 2 goals as well. In their second game against the Brandon Wheat Kings on May 23rd, also in the round robin, the London Knights won 9-1. Christian Dvorak grabbed himself a hat trick, Matthew Tkachuk grabbed himself his first goal of the tournament, and all was well with the London Knights. Then, going over to their final game in the round robin against the Huskies team from the QMJHL, whose city name I really, really don't want to pronounce. They grabbed himself a win in that one as well, which is very obvious, a 5-2 win. Matthew Tkachuk grabbed himself his second, Christian Dvorak grabbed his sixth, and Tkachuk sealed things up with an empty net later on, 3 total goals for him in the round robin. Because the London Knights were really good, they beat all their opponents with ease, they made themselves known all the way going to the finals, and they faced off against the same Huskies team. But they almost lost. In fact, they won the game, yes, they did it 3-2 in overtime, but things were kind of iffy, seeing as the Huskies had a 2-1 lead heading into the final minutes of the game before Christian Dvorak, with 4 minutes left, forced overtime. Matthew Tkachuk earned the Knights the win, and they grabbed himself the Memorial Cup championship in a season that was already filled with amazing successes. So, that's it. That was the season of the London Knights top line Memorial Cup winning, OHL championship winning London Knights team. Carried with an all-star first line. In fact, if you take a look at this first line, Tkachuk as a left winger, Dvorak as a center, Marner as a right winger, these three guys took up the top spots on the first All-Star team in the OHL that season. The first All-Star team was Dvorak, Tkachuk, Marner, Mikhail Sergachev on defense, Rasmus Anderson on defense, Mackenzie Blackwood as a goalie, and the Erie Otters coach as the coach. This London Knights team completely dominated, and although it was evanescent, it was one thing that we will never forget. Mitch Marner went on to make the Maple Leafs the next season. Dvorak went to the AHL, and Matthew Tkachuk went to the NHL as well. All three of these guys today can be found in the National Hockey League, and albeit not with the same amount of success as they did with the OHL's London Knights, guys like Marner and Tkachuk are still finding ways to light things up on fire. Christian Dvorak, on the other hand, is having a little bit of a tough time producing, but you could very well argue it's because of his team. Still, 37 points in the most recent NHL season isn't bad at all. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. To replacing Zidane Shrosling, there for saying gaming, and bye.